So the key measure for remission, because I say it's important to measure police objectively, police, police, police. So one of the measures for remission is certainly lactatus of the members. A little bit also due to my history, because I did my PhD in that area, and also because it is so tricky and so motivating to try to do a good thing. And if you hear a lot of criticism, these things ran off in our lives. But it doesn't mean, because every weekend there are four or five people who die in the crash of the car, that we have to forgive the whole cars. So my reaction on this, this skepticism is more to learn to work with it. And if you have a good manual, if you work correctly with it, you will see there are a lot of possibilities that provide, that like that provides you to optimize your car. You cannot sort of from you. I cannot measure what's the temperature with the environment. So you have to use things where they are both things and for other things. That's what you're talking about. But so, and I will take, I have some time, I will certainly take some, show you some pictures about some thoughts we have and try to make it clear what possibilities of using the electric trailer. What is very young is a lactate curve, and we have a lactate curve for 400 meter freestyle, which is maximum intensity and nearly maximum intensity. And what does the lactate curve tell you? Well, very simple. You have a relation between swimming speed and your relation, and you have according to the concentration of the lactate that you can expect. So that's not more than that. And even here, if now I would not do a 200 meters result, this will not be all the relation between the and speaking remain. It will change. We will have no relation. So already depending on the product, this position of the lactate will already be very, very strong. Now, what is very common is that people are looking for the formula model and to say, okay, that speed is a formula model, and indeed it is a good, let's say, as long as your exercise lasts long enough, you can do it for 1 minute or 2 minutes, at least it must be 4 minutes or 5 minutes, to be a reliable reflection for your endurance based on the formula model. So if your distance or your effort is too long, you may not have the formula as a reference for endurance. That's what I want to say. So first of all, it will give you a very good impression of IP about the endurance. And you see, I don't say capacity of power because we can't play the split here based on this. But endurance, aerobic endurance, all that. You can do it. And the next point where it's very easy, or let's say where it's getting useful, is to make at least the first estimation of some training intensities for service or triathlons. Good. Now, what we found is, in fact, that the position of the lactate curve, or what speed corresponds with what lactate curve, that in fact that's important. Much more important is to reveal what mechanism or what metabolism is active, or is working, or is creating that situation. That's much more important. And what could be demonstrated is that, okay, that's well known. You have a certain oxygen uptake or aerobic capacity, and if your aerobic capacity will improve, then the position of the lactate curve will also move to the right side. That's very common. And in the opposite situation, where your maximum oxygen uptake is decreased, your curve will move to the left. However, this driving force is no longer on a metabolic level. We don't speak about the peak, because otherwise it becomes much more complicated. But simply, from the perspective of metabolism, the position of the is not only determined by the forces going here on the pudding, if you want to see it that way, but also by the capacity to produce. And if I tell you, this is a swimmer who cannot produce much of a plate, I let him swim at 4 or 5 mil, you as a coach, you will come immediately to me and say, yeah, it's not possible. No, it's not possible. If he's not able to produce normally a plate, what should you ask him to already train at 5 mil? For him, it's very, very hard. But what if you have a sprinter who easily can do what he's going to do, and you ask him to swim easy, and you are measuring that pain and it's for you, is it a problem? No. He can produce 20 walks for you. It's much more. Okay? So this is to give you a little bit more simple evidence, because this is a factor which a lot of testing systems don't take into consideration. And then you can end up with a lot of mistakes by interpretation. So what we know is that as soon as the anaerobic capacity increases, it will also pull the curve from the left side. And if the anaerobic capacity is decreased, then it will drive the vapor to the right. So that means that if you want to make an interpretation, a very classic interpretation, thinking that the position of the lactate curve is only driven oxygen system and improving is right and decreasing is left, it's not okay. You have to take in consideration much more possibilities that allow to explain why a lactate curve goes to the right and the left. And that's why very often a lot of mistakes are made in interpretations and coaches end up with more problems. Now, you can imagine if I say for two swimmers to take, this is a cross swim here. He has a very big improvement here tonight and also huge strength. Proportionally less, but also an improvement of the aerobic system. The curve goes to the right. If now I give for that triathlete the same training advice as for the guy who is dying on the aerobic side, and who is even more dying on the aerobic side. How is it possible? We say that's not possible. But that's very often what we see. If you consider the classic way, we say it goes to the right, okay, it's good, you can go, you can swim more, you can swim faster, and you are in this situation where you are making a simulation in the course. So this is to show the importance, not to look only on the aerobic side,